Send your words to barren schools, send your kids to barren schools, a place to realize your dreams, barren schools. Send your words to barren schools, send your kids to barren schools, there's no other place like barren schools.
Hi there, you're welcome back to another e-learner of Barren International Schools. My name is Goodman. I'm basically for GS1 and GS2, and I know that it will equally be beneficial because of the topic. It will equally be beneficial to GS3. So today is GSS1 and GSS2. So I'm going to be talking on lesson writing today. We're going to base our learning today in this part of letter writing, informal letter writing. Informal letters. Now, what is this informal letters? These are letters to close relatives, close relations. And what are these close relations? We're talking about your parents, or our parents, siblings, friends, classmates. Alright, so these are the people. Anytime you write to anybody in this group, in this category, you're writing informal letter. So that is far away from this other one we call formal letter. Actually, I know you know that we have three types of letter, but as you are developing, they will streamline it into two types of letters. So the other one that's called semi-formal letter doesn't really exist. Does not really exist. Because it's going to be subsumed in any of these formal or informal. So when you write to any of the people in this group, you are writing informal letter. So you write to a parent. You write to brothers and sisters, friends, classmates, your acquaintance. So you are writing informal letter. Alright, having identified this grade, the next thing we're going to look at is the format. I think that's where... Alright, so we're going to look at the features. Features of what? Informal letter. Features of informal letters. Now, you know that before you write a very good letter, you should know the parts of that letter. Otherwise, you'll be wasting your time. At the end of the day, you'll not do anything good, anything tangible. So we're going to be looking at the features of informal letters. And now when I say features of informal letters, I'm referring to the structure of informal letters or the part of the informal letters. First of all, number one is address of the writer. Address of the writer. Number two is the date. The date of writing. Number three is salutation. Salutation. Number four is the body. The body of the letter. The body of the letter. And lastly, conclusion. Conclusion of the letter or ending. Ending. Yeah. So, this is the part of informal letter. This is the structure of informal letter. Now, it is a far departure from formal letter. In formal letter, there's additional two parts added to this, making it seven. So, in this place, we have just five. So, when you write informal letter, this is how you structure your writing. Your writing is going to structure along this line. First of all, the address of the writer. That's the person writing and the and then salutation, then the body of the measure and completion. You see, we're going to see a lot of mistakes we've been making when we're writing letters. Because in the class, I remember last year, someone was telling me that the date is part of the address. No, it's never. It's not. It's not part of the address. Let's just look at these five features very well. So I'm going to delete this. If you've not copied, please, I'm giving you a little time to do it. So the number one is address of the writer. That's the first thing you're going to do when writing a letter, whether it's formal or informal. The next one is the date of writing. The date of writing. And then the third one is the salutation. Salutation. Then the number four is the body of the letter. And lastly, the conclusion. That's the end of the letter. So I'm going to delete this so that we start, you know, formatting the letter, or we start writing it the way it should be. Okay? So I'm going to delete this. I hope it is there in your notes. Alright, when we're talking about address of the writer, please do remember that address is always at the top right hand corner of the paper. At the top right hand corner of the paper. So if you have this as the sheet of paper you're going to use, now the address will be somewhere here at the top right hand corner of the paper. Now after this, the next thing is the date that will fall under the address, below the address. Do remember that I said that the fact that the date is under the address does not mean that it is part of the address. So that it is where it is conventionally agreed that it should be. Now, after that, the salutation will now be somewhere here. Somewhere here. Remember that we're looking at the structure of informal letter. Somewhere here, that is where the salutation will be. Then the body will take care of all this place. And then the conclusion is somewhere here. So this is the structure. This is the structure of a letter, informal letter. The address at the top right hand corner, followed immediately by the date, then the salutation at the left hand side, below the address. Now in some cases you can skip a line. You can skip a line. Then after that, the body of the letter, and then the conclusion, which is the end. Alright, now let us take the first one. The address. The address. Okay, let me write. Address. Address. Date. Salutation. Salutation. Body. Body of the letter. And then completion. Completion. So let us see how we can realize this, what we have here in real time. Now, the first thing you need to note about address is that we have two types of address. We have two types of address. We have the one we call block type of address and the one we call indented type of address, or some people say slanted. Let's take the block first, the block type of address. Now, I'm going to give an imaginary address. I'm going to use an imaginary address. It's not my address, and I guess it's not your address. Nobody's living there. But it's a location here in Colorado. So let us assume that I am living at Gold Street. Gold Street. Gold is a street in Colorado. I guess it's in Calabasas. Let's say 60. No, let me write it alone. 60. Remember that it's at the top right hand corner. So I will say 60. Goldie Street. Goldie Street. You put a comma. Goldie's found in Calabar. So you bring Calabar under Goldie. Calabar. And Calabar is in Cross River State. You put Cross River State. Cross River State there. And then you put a full stop. Now, if the letter is going overseas, if it's going outside Nigeria, Then you put Nigeria here. Nigeria. You put Nigeria here. Then you move the full stop here from Cross River State to Nigeria. Then you put a full stop there. Then this place will now be common. Okay? So the other one, the indebted one will look like this. I'm still going to use Goldie. The other one that we call the indebted one will look like this. This is going to be the shape. Goldie Street. Then Calabar will not be here. Cross River State will not move an inch. Then Nigeria will not come down somewhere here. Then you put a full stop there. You contract, you contract. Fine. This is the block type of address. And this is the indented type of address, also known as slanted type of address. Now, the most important thing here is that choose the one you know you can format very well. Choose the one you know you can construct very well that you can do with minimum mistake. Okay? Now, there's no problem. This is for the, okay, let me not say there's no problem. You can leave the punctuation blank, but the moment you put a full stop here, you'll be penalized for not punctuating the other lines. Okay? So, but no problem. Just put the comma, and then when you come to the end, you put a full stop there. Now, you will not be penalized. But the moment you put a full stop here and you refuse to control the other lines, you will be penalized. That is clear. So, 60 and Goldie Street. 60, Goldie and Street should be in one line. Calabar on its own line. Cross River and State should be on another line under Calabar. And then Nigeria should be on its own line. So, don't muddle it up. Of course, you see how we've done it. This is the intended one, this is the block type. So, another important thing you need to know about address is that all the words in an address will start with capital letters because they refer to nouns. These are all nouns. These are all names of places. Goldie is the name of a place. Calabar is the name of a place. Cross River State is the name of a place. Nigeria is the name of a place. So you start them with capital letters. So if you're the one that writes like this, oh yeah, you'll be penalized. You'll be penalized. You'll be penalized. Because this is a compound noun. Cross River State is a compound noun. So you write the initial alphabet of this compound noun. Capital letter. Alright, so that is the two types of address we have in. Now, this is very important. Those of you who think that the date is part of the address, today is 26. Now, look at this. I'll put the 26 here. I'm coming to the date. I'll still talk about the date. 26 November. 2021. Now, look at this. 60 is the number where the writer is staying. And Goldie is the name of the street. And 60 is the number, the location, the place. Now, this Goldie Street is found in Calabar. Calabar is found in Cross River State. Cross River State is found in Nigeria. Do you say Nigeria is found in November? The answer is no. So that is why we say that the date is never part of it. So those people that, you know, class the date as part of, they are making a mistake. So the date is on its own. It's a separate entity from the address. Alright, I hope you've copied this one, but I'm going to delete this one. I'm going to wipe it off so that we can go to the salutation and the date. Alright, so that is the slanting. That is the date that I just deleted. The other one is blocked. Let's get something clear now. Personally, I'm not telling you that that is the the way it is. That's the standard. But when I'm writing, if I'm using block type of address like this, my paragraph equally will be block. I will use block paragraph. But if I'm using the indented one that I've just deleted, my paragraphing will be the indented type of paragraphing. So get that. I'm not saying that is the standard, but that's how I do my one. Alright, now we come to the number two. We're done with the date. Let me take the address. Let me take the address. So we are here now in the date. The date gives us three information. The day of writing, the month of writing, and the year of writing. That is what the date gives us. 26th. Yes, there's something here. It should be like this. 26th. Now, 26th November, you punctuate after the month. Please do write the month in full. Okay, when you're writing, do write the month in full. 26th November, then the year, after the year, you put a full stop. You put a full stop. Now, if you're writing on the first day of the month, you write like this. First. If it is on second, you write like this. Second. If it is on third, you write like this, third. If it is on first, you write like this first. Please don't join the bandwagon. Those who write like this, it is wrong. Don't put the ST up. It's wrong. Or you write second, you do something like this. No, 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 no. Please don't do it. The third one, you do like this. The fourth, from fourth down, you put here. Don't write like this. Please let them be in the same line with the one, with the two, with the third, with this fourth. Let them be in the same line. So what that translates to is that you are saying, if you are saying first, what you are saying is something like this, which we know that is wrong. You don't step first like this. Okay, so that is it. Now you put them in the same line because you are saying first. Now, if you don't put them ST or ND or RD or TH, it means that you're counting the month. You don't write 4th June. 4th June 2021. So this is wrong. This is wrong. If you put 4th June, you do not put the TH. It means that you're saying 4th June. 1, 2, 3, 4 June. Are you getting it? So you need to put the TH, you need to put the RD, you need to put the ND, and you need to put the ST. You know, this means of communication has been bastardized by the advent of phone. Before the coming of phone, people do communicate with their loved ones living very far from them through this means. So whatever you're going to do, this skill, this skill of communication, you have to, you know, do it well so that the person at the other end will get what you're saying. Now, when you don't write the TH there, you put this. It looks as if 4 June, which was the June, you are counting. Which, is it the June of this year or the June of last year? That is the meaning that is given to us. So, you need to put this TH, the RD, the ND, and the ST, and then put them in the same line with the number. Don't put them up like people do. So, that is taking care of it. Remember that I said that the information we get here is that this is the day of writing, this is the month of writing, and this is the year of writing. Alright, so we've gotten that one. We're going to tick that one here. Yes. Already ticked. Now remember that we're writing an informal letter to close relations. So in informal letter, salutation, please get this into your head. Salutation is never greeting. Okay? Salutation is never greeting. It's simply a polite way of identifying the person you are writing to. When you want to identify the person you are writing to in a polite manner. Okay. Now, in this place, the intimacy, the affection, the closeness of this person we are writing to is unlimited. Look at these several salutations I'm going to give to you. Look at it. Now, after the date, you come to this part, the left hand side, your right. Who is Michael there? Okay, let me not use Michael, let me use Michelle. Okay, Michelle. Michelle. Now, this is one, dear Michelle. Now we have, you can equally be like this. My dear Michelle. Still good, still good. This one, another type of salutation. Then, my dearest Michelle. My dearest Michelle, please dot your eye. Don't be like your teacher there. I'm very proud of touching my eyes. Now, the last one. Alright, so the last one, let me bring this one. My darling Michelle. Well, I don't know how you spell your own Michelle, but this I feel Michelle should be spelled. So if it is double L at the end, so please, when you come back to school, let me know. If I do not spell the name very well. Now, look at this. Four different salutations. Very good. Very good. You see that this one can be anybody. This one is a bit, the second one is a bit more intimate, more deeper. When I use my dear, means that the person is very close to me. Then this one, oh my God. And then look at the last one, my daughter Michelle. So these are all the various type of salutation we can employ when writing informal letter, depending on the intimacy you are having with this person you are writing to. For instance, if I'm writing to my wife, I will employ a very, very good intimate salutation for her. So when we say my darling Michelle, it means that this person is very, very close to the person that he is writing to. Now, if I'm not close to you, and I'm employing this type of salutation, when you pick the letter, you say, ah, what is this? When did this one start? So it looks embarrassing to use the wrong salutation for somebody. So what we've been able to establish now is that salutation, to a great extent, highlights the closeness, the degree of closeness we are having with the person we are writing to. All right, okay, I've already ticked them here. So now we now go to the body of the letter. The body of the letter. That is why I said that this topic will be very, very beneficial to just three people, not just one and just two, just three people too. Because this is the body of the letter, we're going to learn a lot of things today. So I'm going to delete this. I hope you've copied this into your notes. I'm going to delete this. Now if you not copy the salutation, you know, you simply dear, I remember something. Now when you start your salutation, please remember that you're going to start the dear with capital letter, then the person's name with capital letter. But when you come to this second one and the third one and the fourth one, please, the dear here will be a small letter because it's an extension of mine. Hello? It's an extension of mine. So you will not make this dear here capital letter because it's an extension of this. But when you come to the name of the person, obviously, it has to be with capital letter. Start with the name with capital letter. So the city here. Alright, so I've given you time to copy the salutation. Now we're not going to the body of the letter. Now, because of just three people and still just three, this body of the letter is divided into three parts. The body of the letter is divided into three parts. Three parts, the body there. We have the body, we have the introduction. Introduction, we have the body proper, and then we have the conclusion. Now this conclusion is different from this one. Okay, this conclusion is different from this one. Now, in the body, is divided into this three parts. This introduction is the first paragraph. Then the conclusion is the last paragraph. Then the body proper takes care of the reasons the reason or reasons of writing. So this one, the introduction is the part, that first paragraph where you will ask the welfare of the person you're writing to, perspective. How are you? How is mommy? How is daddy? How are they doing? How is their work? How is this? How is that? Now that one is the introduction. It takes the first paragraph. Please don't forget it. The first paragraph is always the introduction. Now, don't make your introduction more than one paragraph. So the first paragraph is always the introduction. If you do it more than one paragraph, at the end of the day, you'll be writing out of content. Because before you now come to this part, maybe the time is not there. So you just end up writing nothing. Now, the body proper is where you now give the reason or reasons for writing this letter. And then you make it up with this introduction. And then the letter will flow, naturally flow, it will be cohesive. Naturally flow. Now, how do you make it up? Say, the purpose of this letter, the main reason of this letter, of writing this letter, is to let you know, to tell you how I'm doing in school. To tell you how I'm doing in school. You know, so you now explain in the other paragraph, you now explain how you are doing in school and the problems, the challenges that you are having, and the your performance in school. Now the conclusion here is the summary of what is the body proper. Hope that is clear. Alright. So we are looking at the path of the body. I told you that it's three. Introduction, body proper, and conclusion. Conclusion is the summary of what is in the body. So that is how you structure your writing. When you structure your writing this way, obviously, under organization, you're going to score high. Under organization, you're going to score high. Now, what is here is the conclusion, the summary of what is the body proper. Now, this one is one paragraph, this one is one paragraph. So I assume you're going to write 9 paragraphs in one. So this one will not be 7. Okay? The body proper takes care of a large chunk of the writing. So it will now be 9. 1, 1, 7. That is 9, isn't it? So that is how you write. Make sure that whenever you're writing, you develop your body, the body of the letter, in this manner. When you develop the body of your letter in this manner, my God, you are going to score very high on that organization. Okay. Now, having said that, we're done with the body of the letter. So we're now going to the last part of the letter, conclusion. Conclusion. Now, just like in the salutation, we have many ways of concluding a letter. What is this conclusion? The identification of the person. That's the only place you identify yourself as the writer of the person, or the letter writer. Now, this place you identify the person you're writing. In this place, you identify yourself as the writer of this letter. Okay? Now, how do we identify ourselves as the writer of this letter? We have many ways of identifying ourselves as the writer of this letter. First of all, like this. Yours affectionate. Yours affectionate. You put your name. And now, I did not explain this here. Please, when you are writing a formal letter, it's only the person's personal name that you will use in the salutation, you identify in the salutation. Only the person's first name. So if the person is Michelle Obi, this Obi will not come in. It's only Michelle. Because that is the person's personal name. So when you are concluding too, it's only your first name, your personal name that you will now identify or now use. So when I say just affectionate Ada, Michelle knows the Ada that wrote this letter. So that is one of the ways of concluding an informal letter. Another one is yours sincerely. Yours sincerely. Yours sincerely. You put your name and that. Then You can equally do something like this. Love from Adam. So these are some of the ways you can conclude your informal letter. Please do remember, as I summarize, please do remember that informal letters have 5 parts: the address, the date, the salutation, the body, and the completion. And the address, it depends on the type of address you are going to employ. We have 2 types of address: the slanted and the indented one, or the scanty one. Now, the date gives us 3 information, like you've seen earlier. So you write the day of writing, the month of writing, and the year of writing. Remember that the TH or the ST or the ND will be in the same line with the date, with the not the day you are writing. So remember that you are equally going to start your month with capital letter, because we're talking about now, just like we said that each alphabet in address, each word in address will start with capital alphabet. Then we equally say that the body of the letter is divided into 3 parts: the introduction, the body proper, and the conclusion. So you structure your writing along that part. Make sure that the first paragraph is introduction. The second paragraph is where you now start giving the reason, or reason, the aim of the letter. Now the last one is the summary, summarizing what is in the body. So we just explained this from the conclusion, that the conclusion is just when you sign up, identify yourself as a writer. Now I have something here. I have an aid here that will help me. Even though this is not an informal letter, this is a formal letter. This, what you see here, is the structure of formal letter. You've seen it. This is the address of the writer. This is the recipient address. This is the date. This is the main. In the next class, I will have to look at this formal letter, so that you now see the difference between this, what we are looking at now, this informal letter and formal letter. So this is a typical example of formal letter. Now we are going to come to the part of formal letter, so that you now see that it is 7. Why this one is 5? This is the address of the writer, the date, which is 2. The receiver address. The receiver address is the office that is receiving this letter. So in this place, the receiver address is Berry International Schools, here in the court enable. So this is that's number 3. Then we have the heading or the title of the letter. Now of course you see Approval Center for Basic Education Examination Center, VESEL. Okay, so that is number 4. Now this is the body proper. The body proper, number 5. And then there's something missing. We have address of the writer, 1. The date, 2. The receiver address, yes. That's 1, 2, 3. The receiver address. Then heading, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The body, 6. There's something wrong with this one. It should be 7. It should be 7. Let me see. There's something. Yes. The salutation is there. Sorry, that is what is missing there. The salutation is there. Let me see the other one. Okay. It's 13. So the salutation, that's what makes it 7. So it is a far departure from this. This is when you are writing personal letters to somebody that is close to you. But this one is a public letter. Okay? Somebody you don't really know, is not close to you. But this, the one we're dealing with today, is personal letter you write to somebody who is very close to you. In our next class, we'll take this informal letter and we'll look at it deeply. Alright. So having said that, we call it an end. See you next time. Bye-bye.